Hello, America. Isn't life great here in these United States? Sure, we've had our fair share of problems, but Uncle Sam works around the clock, diligently tending to the scourge of communism, reefer, and the rock and roll. But your country needs your help in battling a problem that is more threatening than all of these combined. The impending zombie apocalypse.
Golly, those zombies are really going to town.
If only they played it smart, little Billy. This whole calamity could have been avoided.
Gee, I know, celebrity. How can I avoid being torn limb from limb?
You know me. I'm Sterling St. John. And in times like these, your survival hinges on four simple steps. Recognize, attack, survival, and panic.
Brass?
That's right. You're a smart kid, little Billy. The first step of RASP is recognize, or understand your zombie. Your average zombie exudes the appearance of death. Look for these telltale signs, such as rotting flesh, halitosis, maggots in ears, and many more.
Gee, Sterling, could my neighbors be zombies?
Only if they look like this.
Oh, ew! Ew!
No. No, Billy. Your neighbors are probably communists. A zombie's motor skill lies somewhere between doorknob and screw top. Zombies move at a pace that can only be described as shambling. That's about the extent of their movement. They can't fly. They can't swim. And they definitely can't run. This mobility restriction is crucial to your survival, little Billy.
It is?
Yes, and don't you forget it. Because if one of them bites you, you become one of them. Forever.
Oh, look! Here comes my sister Barb!
But why are the zombies here? What do they want?
Well, no one is really sure what they want. We have a crack team of scientists working day and night. One thing I do know for sure, they're coming to get you, Barbara.
America, it is our right and our duty to bear arms. Just as our white forefathers defeated the savagely evil red men with our thunder sticks, so too shall we prevail over the army of the undead. Question, how? Answer, guns.
Well, how are you gonna kill something what's already dead?
Well, my simple-minded countrymen, let's leave that question for the professionals.
Thanks, Sterling. Howdy. I'm Sparky Mahoney, weapons and tactical expert for the Exterminators Union Local 242, Southwestern. This fella here, well, that's Chico.
Well, kid muscle, we're here to teach you about the second step of RASP. Attack!
Step two.
Now, we're here on a sweep and clean mission. We've already lost a couple of our comrades, but we should be alright. See, to answer your question about how to kill a zombie, well, it's really quite simple. You destroy the brain by any means necessary. Now, Thea, the thing about zombies, they're none too bright. I mean, you can trap them and trick them with just about anything. Maybe a tape recording of a baby crying. Maybe a tube steak, some sausages. Was that you one time there, Chico? Not a summit. Yeah, that was a good one.
Attack.
Now see, you can shoot a zombie as much as you want. Blow off their kneecap, make them fall down, that's pretty funny. Shoot them in the heart. They're still gonna keep coming at you. You gotta get them in the brain. Hit them in the head.
Yeah, watch this. You can get me, man. You can get me. You can get me.
Weaponry.
Take that, zombie! Don't fuck with Johnny Apocalypse! Ah, damn! I thought this chainsaw would be a perfect weapon for the zombie apocalypse!
How wrong you were, Johnny Apocalypse. See, a chainsaw relies on gas. It's loud and attracts zombies, and it could get stuck on bone or cloth, leaving you vulnerable to attack.
Huh. Well, what should I have used? A machete?
Now let's see this season's essentials.
Automatic pistol.
Larger clip, faster rate of fire.
Home action, shotgun.
Power, devastating at close range.
Machinga.
Accuracy, 30 round clip.
Board we tenere.
Hard wood.
Flail axe.
Ooh.
Damn. I thought fire would be the perfect weapon.
Wrong again, Johnny Apocalypse. All you'll end up with is a burning inferno.
Safety tip.
Always remember, wear your cup.
Now back before the zombie apocalypse, yours truly was just a punk jockey at Big Ed's Gas and Go off of Interstate 35. These days I'm one lean, mean, zombie-killing machine. Perhaps now you're just a lowly tax accountant, or maybe a truck stop waitress. But in this forthcoming zombie apocalypse, there's a whole slew of career possibilities available to you, such as land pirate, forager, mercenary, post-apocalyptic career counselor, and a whore. Well, by this point in time, you've probably mastered the second step of RASP, attack. And this should keep you alive long enough to make it to the third round. But in a zombie apocalypse, things can and usually will go wrong. But just keep in mind these last two simple rules. One, two to the head, zombie be dead.
He made it through us.
I know, Chico, I know. Which brings us to the last rule to the attack round. Leave one bullet for yourself. I don't know about you, but you won't find old Spark and Mahoney eating no American's brains.
I hope there's still room in hell.
I love you, Chico.
I love you too, boss.
Zombie apocalypse! There is no God!
Let's all go to the lobby! Let's all go to the lobby! Let's all go to the lobby to get ourselves a
BRAINS!
It's a beautiful picture, isn't it? The very model of American order and efficiency. Or is it? Do you remember that picture you just saw? Take another look. Not a pretty sight. Something has gone horribly wrong. By now, you should already know how to spot and kill zombies. Good work. But what if? What if, despite your best efforts, something goes horribly wrong? In step 3 of RASP, survival, We teach you the necessary steps when all else fails. The first thing to remember in survival is safety in numbers. The buddy system, your best bet for continued survival, because two heads are better than one. There is, of course, a downside in a zombie apocalypse. You may be forced to shoot your best friend in the face.
I got bit, Stan!
I'm sorry, Tommy.
I broke my leg, Stan!
I'm sorry, Tommy.
I ate the last piece of pie, Stan!
I'm sorry, Tommy.
In the event that you go it alone or someone in your group gets hurt, choosing the right place to hole up can mean the difference between staying alive and having your brain sucked out through your eye sockets. Here's some places to consider. A rooftop. If you have a bomb shelter, use it. But don't forget to stock up on toilet paper.
Fuck!
Sorry, Tommy.
Why not duck into the local bathhouse for a soothing massage?
Ooh, fighting those zombies sure has made you tense. Would you like a quick
lube? Eluding zombies all day long can be taxing, and it will eat up most of your time. Don't let that fact discourage you from having a little fun. Board games are a great example.
Okay, for the pie. What is the single most effective weapon against a zombie at close range? Shotgun! Yes! Yes!
Or try arts and crafts. A little post-slaughter lovemaking is a great way to keep the apocalypse fun. The truth is, you may find it your task to help repopulate America. If you've made it this far, you've clearly proven your genetic superiority.
Wow.
If you follow these simple survival tips, you'll do well to keep things looking like this. And not like this. Good luck.
But Mom, I'm too old for a babysitter. Besides, she smells funny.
How you folks doing? Ho ho, it's just me, Sterling St. John.
Hey, Sterling.
Hey, Sterling.
Looks like these folks know their rasp. But what if? But what if you forgot to lock the door? What if these bullets aren't in that gun? So, what do we do when those first three steps aren't enough? Well, then we go to step four. It's quite simple, it's very easy. Panic. A good panic should involve saying a prayer for the US of A, putting on good running shoes, and heading in any direction that feels right to you. If you must scream, then do it. Just remember to save some of that energy for crying and, if necessary, wetting your pants. There is no shame in a panic.
Praise the Lord!
Praise the Lord!
The bastion ammunition!
Praise the Lord!
Praise the Lord!
The bastion ammunition!
Praise the Lord!
Praise the Lord!
The bastion ammunition!
And we'll all stay free!
Pass the ammunition.
far cheesy.